Hello. Welcome once again. In this video series, we will see what Niagara is and how to use the Niagara system for creating excellent VFX. In the earlier videos in this series, we have seen the making of static meshes in some balloons flying. In this video, we will take a look at setting up a Niagara emitter so that particles and lights are spawned at the same time. Please like this video if you find it helpful and informative, and subscribe to our channel for newer updates and game development tutorials. So let's start. When you give particles the ability to illuminate the world around them, it can add an extra layer of realism to any of your project's visual effects. We have some prerequisites. In this video, we will use the adl_gradient material, which is found with the starter content. You should create a new project that includes the starter content, or use a project that was created with starter content included. First, create the system and emitter. Niagara emitters and systems are independent. The current recommended workflow is to create a system from existing emitters or emitter templates. First, create a Niagara system by right-clicking in the content browser, and from the displayed menu select FX and then Niagara system. The Niagara emitter wizard displays. Select the Create System menu. Now select New System from selected emitters, then click Next. Now open System wizard. Under Templates, select Fountain. Select Fountain template. Click the plus sign icon to add the emitter to the list of emitters to add to the system, then click Finish. Name the new system as Particle Light. Double-click to open it in the Niagara editor. The emitter instance in your new system has the default name of Fountain. You can rename it, however. Click the name of the emitter instance in the system overview, and the field will become editable. Name the emitter Particle Light. Now drag your Particle Light system into your level. When you make a particle effect, it is always a good idea to drag your system into a level. This gives you a chance to see every change and edit in context. Any changes you make to the system automatically propagate to the instance of the system in your level. Now edit the emitter update group settings. First, you will edit the modules in the emitter update group. These are behaviors that apply to the emitter and that update each frame. In the system overview, click the emitter update group to open it in the selection panel. Open emitter update group. Expand the emitter state module. Because you used the fountain template, the life cycle mode is set to self. Click the drop down and set the life cycle mode to system. This enables your system to calculate the life cycle settings, which usually optimizes performance. So set life cycle mode. The spawn rate module creates a continuous stream of particles while the emitter is active. This module is already present in the fountain template. Set the spawn rate to 500. Now edit the particle spawn group settings. Here you will edit the modules in the particle spawn group. These are behaviors that apply to particles when they first spawn. In the system overview, click the particle spawn group to open it in the selection panel. Open particle spawn group. Expand the initialize particle module. This module collects several related parameters together in one module, minimizing clutter in your stack. Under Point Attributes, locate the Lifetime Mode drop-down and set to Random. This parameter determines how long particles will display before they disappear. For this effect, you will use a dynamic input called Random Ranged Float to randomize how long the particles display. Random Ranged Float is already applied to the Lifetime parameter in the Fountain template. Set the minimum and maximum values as minimum 1.75 and maximum 2.5. Also under Point Attributes, locate the color parameter. This sets the initial color of the particles when they spawn. Set the RGB fields. The Unreal Engine color picker normalizes RGB color values to an integer between 0 and 1. However, if you set a color value greater than 1, it becomes emissive color. The particles will glow that color when the system is placed in the level. Red is 0.1. Green is 0.50. Blue is 0.1. Under Sprite Attributes, locate the Sprite Size parameter and check the box to enable it. To add some randomness to the size of the fountain particles, adjust the Sprite Size mode. Click on the drop-down menu and select Random Uniform. This adds minimum and maximum fields to the value. Set the Sprite Size minimum and maximum values as minimum 2.5 and maximum 8.0. Sphere location controls the shape and origin of where sprites spawn. You can set the size of the sphere shape by indicating a radius. The sphere location module is included in the fountain template. Set the sphere radius to 15. The fountain template also contains the add velocity in cone module. This adds movement to the particles when they spawn. The point of the cone is at the particle spawn point, and you can set x, y, and z values to determine in which direction the cone expands. The velocity strength has a dynamic input called random ranged float applied. Now set the minimum and maximum values, and leave the other settings at their default values. Minimum is 300, and maximum is 600. Now you will edit the modules in the particle update group. These behaviors apply to an emitter's particles and update each frame. In the system overview, click the particle update group to open it in the selection panel. The gravity force module simulates how gravity affects objects. The drag module applies drag to the particles, which slows them down. The default settings for gravity force and drag work for this effect, so you can leave them that way. Without setting up a collision, the particles in your effect will just fall through the flow or any other solid objects on the level. To add a collision module, click the plus sign icon for particle update and then select collision, and then finally again collision. This adds collision module. The collision module is inserted at the bottom of the stack, after the solve forces and velocity module. This causes an error. Click fix issue to move the collision module and resolve the error. Leave the default settings for the collision module in place. Now you will add the light renderer to the fountain effect. In the system overview, click the render group to open it in the selection panel. Click the plus sign icon for render and select light renderer. Set the radius scale to 5.0. This determines how far from the particle spawn point the light spreads. So do light renderer settings. The color add values enable you to change the color of the light emitted by the effect. These values are labeled with X, Y, and Z. However, they correspond to RGB values, with X equals red, Y equals green, and Z equals blue. To match the light color with the particle color, set the values. Red is 0, green is 15, and blue is 0. Congratulations! You have created an effect that includes a particle light, and that emits light in your scene. Hope this video will help you to initiate your journey into the creative world of Niagara. Thanks a lot, see you in the next video.